scared the shit out of me. Oh, you remember me, eh? I'm your old friend Mick, old Uncle Mick, McTainer. Anyway, I guess Halloween's coming up. Oh, it makes no difference to me, mind you. You know, you enjoy your Halloween as much as you want, dress up in your costumes. I don't really care. What I like to do on Halloween is it might be a little different than what you like to do. For starters, I enjoy eating an entire box of gummy body parts. get these open out. Let's see what we got. Ah, look at this. Straight off the bat, we got a bloody finger. I'm eating a gummy bloody finger. Oh, look at this. Here's a gummy hat. I suppose this is the time of year when you might wind up a head on a stick if you don't be careful. Sorry, I'm starting to choke on gummy body parts. What are you laughing at me? No, it's all right. No, it doesn't matter to me. I mean, everyone has a sense of humor in their own way. But I don't know what you find so fucking funny. That's my problem. So, would you like the knife? That's a big knife. I'm not gonna say it. I know you want me to say it, but I'm not gonna say it. Oh!
Do you want the hookie?
What's going on? 2-for-1 Fangria. Fangria? What is that? Look at this. They even have a sidewalk setting. Too bad it is way too fucking hot to sit out here and drink wine. Come, let us go inside. I've been here before. My friend Kari introduced me. Now I am bringing my wife. Who's that guy behind the bar?
I'm Creighton.
Creighton!
That's me.
Creighton, I can't decide whether to keep up the stupid Dracula voice or just relax and be myself. So, dude, what is the deal with this place? I mean,
pretty cool place, huh?
I love it. Does this place fill up ever?
Friday, Saturday nights. Last weekend, I actually had to turn people away. Every seat was full.
Yeah.
Standing shoulder to shoulder. Yeah. It was a pretty crazy place.
Wow. Where's the vineyard located?
Now, we got three different vineyards.
Yeah.
So predominantly everything from the Vampire Vineyard to Santa Maria.
Okay.
Everything with the Dracula Vineyard.
Okay.
Like this label is coming from Paso.
Everybody loves vampires.
Right? And everything from True Blood is coming from Napa.
Right. Sometimes I have to make a wee-wee, and they have a bathroom here marked count! I like the fact that they have a creepy spider pumpkin atop the toilet! And look at these! You can watch creepy, spooky vampire movies in the men's room while you make a boom-boom! I'm holding the 2012 True Blood Chardonnay. And we're going upstairs to the vampire lair. This is where I just want to spend the rest of my days, sitting in the dark, drinking wine in a vampire's cape. It is like the soil where dead people are buried in.
Well, that's going to be a selling point. you stand in the middle and do a Stevie Nicks twirl.
And now for the Stevie Nicks twirl. I don't want to knock over a wine glass.
Yeah, please don't.
Getting daisies.
Creighton just handed me an actual vampire dark chocolate bar. Dark chocolate is the only way to go. And we are pairing this with the Dracula...
Syrah.
Get the fork out of here. Vampire is even carved directly into the chocolate. Okay. Wait, let me turn off my technology. All right, are you ready?
You're a modern vampire.
The Dracula Syrah paired with the vampire dark chocolate. First, you should take the chocolate and put it into your mouth. And suck on it just a little bit, like you're biting on the neck of a porcelain-skinned woman unbeknownst that you are in her bedroom at night. Okay, here we go, ready?
It mellowed out a vampire.
Oh my god. It's like liquid sex. And paired with the dark chocolate, it is the most hedonistic experience I think I've had this week. Wow, Creighton.
Pretty good?
Creighton is trying to seduce me! Talk to me, brother.
So what I think is interesting about wine, for the longest time, I feel like people thought that it was much more complicated than it is.
Yeah.
And I appreciate what you guys are doing, because I think it opens it up to a bigger segment of the population. There's a lot of us, especially people younger, my age, mm-hmm. that are getting into wine, realizing that it's not necessarily for the uber wealthy, for the one percenters. It's for everybody. It's approachable, and I think this kind of medium is perfect for that. So.
Creighton, I think you nailed it!
Thank
Salud,
you.
Brother.
Salud.
This is a guy who knows what's going on. Vampire Vineyard, Beverly Hills, tasting room, the vampire lair upstairs. I don't know what more you need. It all happens here, and it's sundown.
Yum.
The name is Casper. Just one word, like Cher. Everyone knows it.
I'm Blaze. I'm a fashion force.
I just want to go to Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week and show the world who Hurga is. What Hurga is saying about fashion and what you should wear. And everything else is beneath.
Hi, Death. How are you? Oh, so talk to me. Death, honey, I'm sorry to say it, but I just feel like you're not thinking outside the box. Is there any other material besides long, drapey, drabby blacks that speaks to you? What about crimson? Well, you keep at it, okay? I believe in you. Make it work.
I had to wash my beard one day after working with Death. Not a fun person to be around, I must say. I think the guy has an attitude. Quite honestly, I don't know where that attitude comes from. It's a little unjustified. I mean, sure, you have a lot of power over people, but power is really nothing without style. I think the two, as I said before, go hand in hand.
That whole rotting crypt smell that he's got going on, it's a total tactic, okay? You know, because we're all in there just trying to work, and oh my gosh, all of a sudden, the stench of 40,000 years just kind of like wafts through the room, dude.
The things that I hear about Death are that he is a loner, that he makes no friends, and this is true. I mean, he's Death. I hear him walking around the apartment all night long, and I'm like, Death, please, we're trying to sleep here. He doesn't know how to sew, particularly. He's he doesn't know how to accessorize, but, you know, I would rather have death in the competition than, Casper.
Hulga, you promised to share the scissors. You took them off the table, and you said I could have them back anytime I wanted. All I had to do was say, Hulga, scissors, please. I'm saying Hulga, scissors, please. Would you like me to say, please, scissors, Hulga?
I do not recognize his name. Hulga. Hulga. Try it again. Hulga.
Hulga.
Hulga, with the umlaut.
Hulga.
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 No. Use your lips. Use your lips. Hulga.
Hulga.
Now you're just making fun of me. You're making fun of me.
I am not making fun of you. I'm trying to say it. Hulga.
But do you need the eyes? Hulga. You're looking like
fine,
it's a
no
crazy
eyes
thing.
This time. Hulga.
Remember that.
Are those your grandmother's scissors?
Yes.
What is that over there?
Thank you.
Death is very standoffish. Although we don't try making friends around here, to be honest with you, it's best when you're in this type of environment that you really don't make friends because, you know, on any occasion you could be. And that's especially true with death.
Huh. A black sheet. Wow, that's great. You know, that's what you did for last week's challenge, was it? Oh, yeah, and then the week before that, you used black sheets. And then I think that, wasn't the first challenge you used like a black sheet? Your versatility, man, is like crazy. Wow, you are really talented, man.
Here you are. These are my grandmother's scissors. Perhaps you remember her. Her name was...
You know something, Death? I'm so glad that I found you here. I've got words with you today, buddy. I've got big words with you. You come into my life, you stink, you make everybody miserable, nobody likes you, you have a terrible sense of fashion. Nobody wants you.
Designers? Death, honey, I have to say, I am very disappointed in you, okay? You can't just go around murdering all of your fellow designers. I'm gonna need you to pack up your cubby and leave. Oh, I'm gonna miss you. Love you. Make it work.
I'm really excited right now about hoops, okay? Hoops, because I feel like the line, it's all about the line of the hoop. And, I mean, if you look at this, what does this say to you? It says, wear me. Wear me. And I feel like when I get this in my hands, it just says to me, cardigan.
I had to wash my beard one day after working with Death.
Go on.
Yes. I will start again.
Right. And? Do you live on almonds?
Do I live on almonds? The little nut things? No. Who lives on almonds? Oh, there you are.